The thoughts, opinions, and most importantly the perspectives expressed in this show are solely those of the participants including all guests, and do not reflect the opinions or practices of More Heights Media and or any of its production or advertising partners. Furthermore, More Heights Media does not endorse or condone all topics discussed during this broadcast. This show is purely for entertainment.
Was it toxic though?
You don't think so?
Yeah, you said it was your best beat.
I guess.
And now all of a sudden it's like, hey, what's going on there?
Exactly. But yeah. It's like, am I doing it just for that though?
Does it matter?
I knew this guy was going to say that.
Push us probably.
If Push though, came out.
If he came out right now and he just sprayed the block, I'm listening. He's the right guy to make a move right now. I need to be his PR. Like,
I'm not mad at that take, you know. Yeah, I'm scared, eh?
That'd be like, so crazy.
I'm getting kind of nervous.
That would be so crazy.
Toronto might, like, we might be in for something at this point.
You've been writing more bars?
Imagine if he got everybody's story lens as to why they have an issue with this one guy.
But check this out.
And then he puts together the bars based off of what they share with them.
The hard part.
Check this out.
Shout out all the Avengers, yo. These guys are out here trying to take out Drake.
That's all you're going
to
do? You're going to give a little snippet?
That's the one that you should have ran.
That's the one I should have ran?
Yeah, but we got
shit to get to, bro.
This guy runs a whole bunch of whatever. And what? Then the one track I actually get into is like, oh, we got a bunch of shit to get to. God damn.
Like, come on, man. I could spend all day playing this music
God
stuff.
God damn.
Don't help in Notches out here making up a bunch of noise, though. Yo, what's up, Notch? You ready to do this or what?
Only going up this year.
If you don't know already, it happens to be SUP gang gang. I guess the gang's looking kind of thin this week though.
Only going up this year.
Big up Knots behind the scenes.
Fuck this by your chum. This for that by your chum.
Zealous authentic pictures keep him booked. Keep them busy.
I feel him.
Big up Pri. Anywhere she's at, she ain't with us this week. She's got some shit to take care of. The other guy,
Face Mom,
he is not here either this week. So you got SB and I. I go by the name of Bun. You can find me on Instagram at wha'SUP Bun. This guy over here to my right goes by the name of SB the Student. Find him on Instagram at SB
the Student. There you go.
If you want to join his book club, you better do it hard fast, because time's
DMs.
Ticking, right? How's that song? What's that Yo Gotti song again? It goes down in the DMs. Yeah, if you want to get in that book club, find him in the DMs.
Now let's get it all in perspective.
Yo, what's up, bro?
I don't know where to
week
start.
For us, I guess. I feel like we were just here the other day, huh?
Yeah.
Shout out that late night session.
Only going up this year.
Pause.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. But... I mean, I'm still bumping that Drake shit, yo. Can't lie, still. I'm still bumping the Drake shit.
It's getting interesting, though.
What?
Oh, no.
It's not getting interesting.
Everyone's complaining about it. What is it? Tupac's brother came on and said, yo, I don't like how I got weaponized.
Man.
And I'm like, would he still say that if Kendrick did it or someone else did it?
What Drake did was creative.
They're talking about suing and stuff.
Anyway, we can get to some more of that stuff after. How about we start with how your week has gone so far?
I'd rather check in with you, yo. Oh, you always feel like, you know, you never got to say it. What's popping with you? My weekend was short.
Your weekend?
Yeah. Like, I felt like it flew by pretty quick.
I mean, all of my weekends typically fly by pretty quick.
Mm-hmm.
What did I do this weekend? Saturday I was at work. Then we had a party for my niece, which I happened to miss because I thought it started later in the evening versus earlier in the day. Sunday, right back at it, went back to work, and then...
You missed the whole thing?
What?
The whole party? Yeah.
Not the whole thing, but, well, yeah, kind of the whole thing.
How's it kind of? Either you missed it or you didn't.
See, that's just it. When I got here,
God, I'm asking questions like I feel like pre right now.
What?
You missed it, you didn't. Like I'm
nah, it's like when I got, by the time I got there, it was sort of dying down.
Mm.
So I caught the tail end of it, and then things sort of wrapped up.
Birthday party?
Yeah, it was her birthday.
Hopefully her present makes up for that then, huh?
I'm kind of lacking in that department as of late, to be honest.
That's your department, though.
It is, for the most part, but... it's hard to find time for anything, man. I promise you.
You're becoming you're becoming second place unk the way this is going right now.
Funny enough, I've kind of seen my I'm going to try to say this in a way that it makes sense. I feel like I'm able to see other people's lens, like their perspective of me.
Interesting.
And this is going back to even high school days, because I was having a conversation with a close friend the other day, and just some of the things that we were talking about led us there, and
it
had me thinking about how other people may have viewed me back in the day and even now.
How much you're
like, because you could think that people know you to be something, but you could be totally off with what it is that they think of you. Ultimately, none of that should really matter, they say, but it's like, you ever wonder what somebody's opinion might be of you? You okay over there, bro?
If I ask for it. You gonna pull a call with your niece?
What do you mean?
The apology.
For missing the party?
Yeah, and the gift.
Nah, I wouldn't go so far to say that, but I almost feel like... I don't need to apologize for things, but there's conversations that I feel like I should probably have. And I mean, I've been having them.
Mm.
It's kind of like I'm able now to see things from your lens. So I want to acknowledge that. I hope you don't think this way of me based off of some of these experiences, but I can understand why.
You might be wrong, though. Like you're looking from their lens, but you're still looking through their lens with your perspective. So whatever you think that they see you as, they might not even see you as that. Whereas you're like, yeah, I was late. I'm just making this up. I'm not saying you said this, but like, oh, I was late. I missed it. Then you got a gift, whatever, whatever. She might just be like, yo, he's busy. He's got a lot going on.
Well, if you're thinking at it like, but if I apply slacking. To the, so if I apply to the same sentiment that that friend shared with me,
yeah,
was back in high school, we'd run into each other.
Mm.
But we would never say anything to each other. And okay. She just always thought that I was very mean.
Mm.
Just based off of that interaction.
See, that says a lot about them too.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Because in my head, I was like, yeah, well, you didn't say anything to me.
I was looking at it more like, what? Instead of, you said she, right?
Yeah.
So instead of her thinking that you're mean, she could have just thought you're quiet. You know what I mean?
I guess. But according to her, I would give her these looks, like these mean looks.
Oh.
But I've always known that I wouldn't necessarily come across as the most inviting person. Like, I don't walk around with a smile. So it's like my door is open for you to be like, oh, come say hi to me.
Yeah, some things haven't changed. You should be like, yeah, I'm still like walking around like that.
But Nats, would you say that? For like my demeanor for the most part, is it inviting? Because you've known me longer than he has.
You think it's inviting?
No.
Thank you. I feel like I had to influence that.
Yeah, but
it's funny. Like, I know you well. So for me, I know how to communicate with you. I know how you think. I know when you're in your moods. I know when you're in your thoughts.
Sounded
I know
like a girl or space. Something, bro. Like, this is weird. I mean,
pause all over this. No, but we go back.
Yeah, we go back at least
15, 20 years.
Yeah.
Right. But I say all of that to say that even till this day with me knowing you so well, your disposition, a lot of times, especially when you're in your thoughts, isn't inviting.
Mm.
And there are even moments where I would have to kind of pick my pockets, want to communicate with you. Even SB knows. When SB has a question for you or try to converse with you, we just had it right before we recorded. Are you going to answer?
Exactly.
And you don't.
Answer what?
He will ask a question. Somebody will ask you a question.
Oh, am I going to answer?
and because you're processing other thoughts. Because
there's so many layers to everything.
Or just simply you're in your miserable mood. You don't want to answer.
Yes. Yeah, but hold on. But what kind of questions do you have to ask me today?
Please hear in the spirit. This is great. Anything. Simple stuff, bro. Sometimes just asking you a simple question, it's like.
So then fuck it. We're scratching every topic that we had to go with for a little bit. So shoot, give me a question. What's up?
Like the question that I just asked you is what he's referring to. We're talking about one of our hot topics, the trial that's coming up. I'm like, yo, so do you know enough about the trial? And you're like, did you get a chance to check it? And it's like, I answer that, but you didn't answer what I asked you. You just threw a question back. So I'm like, are you going to answer the question? You know, it's like, yo, that's exhausting.
Okay, so I'm going to go on my phone right now, right? I'm going to go on my phone right now. Somebody had messaged me earlier, and based off of the way I read it, it suggested to me that they said it with angrily, right? So then I messaged them and I go, when you typed all of that and said it in your head while you were typing, were you saying it angrily?
Was it in caps?
What?
The message?
No.
Okay.
But just based off of the wordplay and whatever. So then the response was some other stuff that I'm not going to read. But then the second part to it was, however, you always do that. Never answer my question, but answer me with a question.
Yeah.
Literally the last person that messaged me.
Yeah, yeah. That was literally, I'm literally the last person you had a conversation with. It's pretty bad.
Yeah. Eh?
Yeah.
Do you think there's an art to it, though?
If it was done intentionally.
But it is.
I don't think it is.
All right. I'm working on it, though. I'm going to get better. I'm going to do better. I promise the both of you guys. I'm just going to let it free. Just.
Yeah, should I keep counting every time you do it, though? Like, to make it obvious?
Yeah.
All right.
If only she were here today.
Nah, this would have dragged out like another 30 minutes then. Like we got there.
Nah, but I feel
we
got like, resolution. I feel like she would already have a bunch of questions to ask me.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you want me to fill in some questions?
I mean, you know where I think she would have started?
Who's that girl? Why are you talking to her again? Where is it going? That whole route?
Damn, well, I didn't even think about that part. Mm. I thought it would have went back to the message that I put in the group last night.
Oh, I didn't know if you wanted me to bring that up.
Well, you thought
I was trying to be a bro.
I mean, we could still just edit all of this out.
Yeah, okay. In that case, then, yo.
Do
you see, man? Yeah, hold on. Do you see how things manifest?
Yes. It was frightening to me. I swear to goodness. It was very frightening.
Frightening?
To me.
You should be excited. Like, oh, shit. Like that?
Okay, from that perspective, I see what you're talking about.
Actually, no. I'm going to give you a new one because of how toxic that actually was.
Put things in this proper perspective.
Yeah. Was it toxic, though?
You don't think so?
Yeah, you said it was your best beat.
I guess.
And now all of a sudden it's like, hey, what's going on there?
Exactly. But yeah. It's like, am I doing it just for that, though?
Does it matter?
I knew this guy was going to say that.
In your realm, does it?
I mean, for context, whether or not we leave this in here, I guess.
Yeah, go. You give the context.
A couple episodes ago, we got to some point in the conversation where I had referenced sharing a story about being out one night and telling my close friend that up until a certain point in life, that had been the best vagina that I've ever received.
Pump it up!
Funny. So then, you guys said I should reach out or something like that? How did we get to that part?
Something like that. I'm like, yeah, why don't you reach out again?
Yeah, the suggestion was that I should somehow get a hold of this girl and then, I don't know, I was like why? And then, these guys are on some O for that.
So give some context. How did this happen?
How did what happen?
I was telling you, I'm like, yo, you should message her and be like, yo, I just had a dream about you or some BS line. But how did it happen then?
Let me go back so I can quickly reference what episode it was for anybody who wants to catch along, just in case.
That's going to take too long.
No, I got it.
Is he doing it right now? Is this intentional or did this just happen right now?
There was the No Diddy episode. It was the No Diddy episode.
Yeah. So who reached out to who? What happened?
She out of nowhere, bro, at 5:52 yesterday or something like that.
In the morning?
No, in the afternoon. Okay. Let me double check. 502.
Yeah.
502 got a message.
Yeah.
And it says, I see some things never change. Because my number has always been the same. Mm. I haven't changed my number since.
So are we safe to just like say 07? that's almost like a...
Who you know who's had a number since 07?
I might be up there.
Your number still the same? Like 06, 07? Even maybe, yeah. Mine,
I'm up
mine might even be before that. I'm just not 100% sure, but I can guarantee, no matter what, it's been at least since 07.
How far
it may have been before that, but...
So I'm not really like into your business like that, but just for the
actually,
context,
you know what? I'm lying. It would have to have gone back to like 03 based off of this phone number.
How'd that whole thing go?
What, the conversation?
Yeah.
And my response and everything?
Are you about to hit it?
Well, we're not there yet, bro. It's only been...
No, but is that the angle that you're... Is that the vision?
Is that the vision?
Is that the vision?
I haven't thought that far yet.
Okay.
I mean, I thought back. I thought back to the old visions and I was like, damn, yo. But... You would already be there with that?
She don't look the same, huh?
I haven't even... I don't know. I'm going off of one picture on WhatsApp, but like... What?
So you did go off that one picture.
What are you talking about?
Like you did go check out the picture. So
it's right there in front of me. Yo, you mean like to open it?
Yeah.
Oh, I was trying to make sure who this is because I see a random number pop on my phone. I message me like, yo, who is this?
Oh, so you never had the number yourself?
No, I never had the number on my phone. And even for that, some of that back information, I hadn't seen her since I ran into her late last year. But prior to that, it's been years, like a really long time. Like a very long time. Nothing. No communication. No anything.
Yeah, let's dissect this just for fun, right? Without me knowing any more information. So is it safe to assume that she's leading that way? Just with that little message out of the blue?
Me, at this stage in life, I'm not going to assume that. I'm not going to assume anything at this point.
All right, it's going to be a whole bunch of pauses, but let's just have some fun, right? So you said that like, yo, she's like the best.
Mm-hmm.
Where do you think she ranks you?
Where do you think she ranks me?
Yeah.
Oh, that's interesting.
We need pre.
I don't know. Damn, yo. Damn, that just messed me up, yo. I don't know. Probably, this is like so long ago too, so this is before, yeah, man, nah, probably not that good still, can't lie.
Okay.
Yeah, but
So you're going to try to avenge that loss?
So now you really have me thinking about this. Like
now you should be myself. Like, yeah, exactly. Now you should be like, yo, I got to do it there. I got to do the whole thing, go the whole way and like, you know, make her think about me for the next 10 years.
Okay, but should I share that clip with her though?
Yeah, 100% you should. You share this one too? We shouldn't have any of this. In fact, you could even ask her the question. Yo, where do I rank?
Or did she see that clip?
See that, exactly. Exactly.
But would she know it's her? How would she know it's
exactly?
Her? That's a lot of confidence. Shout out to her.
But that, like, I thought about a couple of these things already too.
It's a lot of experience too. Shout out to her again. Unless there's some other way that she knows all this.
I don't think so. There's no way.
Mm. Anyway, maybe we'll have her as a guest.
Unless, you know what? There might just be actually.
There always could be. This guy's getting excited. This guy dropped the tone of his voice and everything. God, we need some female energy in here.
Tell me about it. We do, to be honest. Yeah, so what else you got?
About what?
That topic. You don't care to ask anymore?
About her?
Yeah.
Nah, I don't really. Where is it going? Give me like an idea of where it's heading.
I have no idea, to be honest.
So what do you want me to ask you, bro? I keep getting the I don't know where it's going. I don't know where I'm planning to take it.
Yeah, but
you gotta have some sort of idea.
Hold on, if you were me, you would have already invited her over or something.
I'm not saying that. It's case by case. I don't know your scenario well enough, other than that it was the best beat that you had time ago. I need more context of what the heck's going on. Even her reaching out, like other than what she asked you, where is the conversation going? I could coach you.
No, just some random shit. Like, what's up? Catching up. Just on some catch-up shit.
Okay.
How's life been going? What you been up to? Da-da-da-da-da type shit.
How often does that happen, though?
This is yesterday, bro.
No, I get it. But, like, how often does that happen?
What? The messaging back and forth?
Yeah. The conversation. Like, even prior to. Was there that friendliness?
When we see each other?
No, when you would talk, when you would converse.
Yeah, but it's been 20-some-odd years or whatever how long it's been.
Since you guys talk like this?
Yes.
So just out of the blue, yo, what's up?
What, you think I'm joking, bro? Like, no, literally out of nowhere.
So there's
out of nowhere.
So you wouldn't automatically like start thinking about where this energy is coming from. Like, yo, you got my number. You just messaged me out of the blue.
I mean, I asked that part. I'm like, where did you dig my number out? Like, what crate did you dig my number out of?
How'd that go?
It was one of those, she never forgot it. She always had it in her head. I was like, yeah, eh? But I mean, it's a pretty basic number.
In her head?
You know it. What?
She always had it in her head. That's what she said? Really? Yeah. Interesting. Maybe she's been thinking about you. Maybe you're the one for her too. Look at that. You guys are going to hook up. Maybe it's going to be one of those. Hey, you know what another thing is, though? What? You ever, like, have an amazing beat, right? And you think about it.
Why are you saying beat?
Oh, it's just, like, how I talk. And then, well, you want me to keep saying market, right? Beat sounded better. And you revisit it. Let's just say 3, 4, 5, a decade later. And it doesn't hold up no more. Actually, before that, has that even happened?
What? Something that I had way back in the day and
you play it back like,
oh, it's better now.
Yeah, eh?
Yeah.
Every time?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm a new man. Once I started flying these guys, bro.
But it's not just you. Only I'm not talking about no. You misunderstood.
What? Like, yeah, but I'm turning this up.
The other person's got it.
No, but trust me, my energy is enough for them. And them, like, knowing me from, like, way back when,
yeah,
it'd be different now.
What's different, though?
Just, I guess.
The kites?
Exactly. And the freedom it allows.
What is freedom?
He's lasting
longer. I just don't care. Yeah. What that part, too. Like, I ain't gonna lie, brother. What don't, like, you care, trust me.
Eating groceries?
You say you're freer.
Dude, that shit still makes me laugh, eh? Like, the 1-2 times I've seen that shit back, bro. Shout out the last tapes, dog. This fucking guy. Check out our Patreon. not that part. Say what?
You gotta get on that.
Nah, not that. Just, it's like I get
It
turns into an experience. Like I said, I've talked about it before with the music, the lights.
Got better playlists.
The everything. So it's not just you're in a bed. Like, you get what I mean? Like, it's not. This is a vibe now. This is a vibe right along with that.
So then let's get personal. So then when you're actually in your activity, are you looking more so to pleasure her?
For sure.
Are you barebacking?
Or you?
Yo, you guys are shooting questions real quick. So what the fuck? Hold on. Am I looking more
because,
to?
Yeah, because it becomes a
It becomes a competition for myself. And FaZe has talked about this before.
What does that mean?
It's like I'm not worried about me, and it's like I'm trying to test my limits to see how well I can perform right now. And I'll do the dumbest shit in there sometimes, bro.
So how's that competing?
It's like,
yeah. Give an example of a dumb thing that you'll do in there, other than the DJing thing.
A dumb thing?
Yeah, you just said it yourself. You're like, I'll do the dumbest things in there. Give an example of a dumb thing that
you'll
do in there.
I mean, to me, it's like, who do I nah, okay, there's a, I don't, what day was that?
Don't worry, just answer the question.
I'll count down.
Yeah.
Like, if I know they're about to come, I'll count down.
Yeah.
And then it happens.
Like, out loud?
Yeah.
Okay.
You've ever tried that?
Nah, I don't think I've done a countdown.
Bro.
Like out loud? Like I'm counting down with her while she's doing it?
Yes, I will count down. And it's happened like a couple times. Yeah. Literally counting down. Like I know when it's going to happen. And I don't know if that like messes with them mentally, but it works. I mean, I'm all here giving secrets, but I promise you, I've done it. It's happened a couple times. So.
Countdown, how? Do you whisper? Do you say it aggressively?
Whisper. Yo, it's pretty.
Listen, priest, I know. I'm like, to fulfill the questions.
I feel
for
like
her.
We need to call her or something, bro. Like, this is weird. Well, what? Let me school some of these guys out here. Then. What?
What do you mean, countdown? Like, do you whisper five, the countdown?
Four.
Do you say it out three. Loud? Yeah, do you say it aggressively sure. While you're pumping?
I got a better one. What? Yeah, what about when you're off? like, yo, you're at like one. And it's like one, no. Zero, like it's not hidden.
No.
No?
No.
You haven't hit that level of vulnerability on this show, eh? This guy just wants to hit it.
What do you mean? Just in terms of a count?
Like you said, I do the countdown and I've gotten it right a couple of times. I'm asking, yeah, what about on, when you don't get the count right? You're doing your countdown from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's like she doesn't know what the countdown is. She hasn't busted.
No, it hasn't happened. I mean, yo, lucky me. What? Now you guys are going to fuck up my run because I'm not even talking about it.
I'm not fucking up nothing.
Whatever.
I'm trying to engage in this conversation. Mm. Get more of what's, you know, like,
yeah, but what's in there. So then what? Let me know what you, yo, what this, we can't be having this kind of conversation.
Who cares a fuck?
This is weird.
I don't even care right now.
What?
I don't even care right now. Like,
some grown man shit.
Exactly. Done. Like, yo, like, what, you don't have these conversations off the cast. Like,
no, I don't. To be honest, I don't talk about my sex life like that with anybody.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah. Who the fuck are you talking? Who are you talking to?
Whoever wants to know. Yeah. Yeah. I'm completely open with it, but ideally, it wouldn't be too many guys in this setting, I guess. But I'm open to the conversation because I feel like a whole bunch of people are gonna be listening and be like, "Yeah, I get that," or "What the fuck?" Either way, I'm good.
Damn it! What was I gonna say now?
I'm on that Ryan Garcia tip right now.
We'll get to that. We'll get to see that. But what, do you get what I mean though with the countdown thing though?
Yeah, I get what you're saying. Give me more dumb
shit.
And
I'm not necessarily timing it with each pump, let's say, but it's just like whether it's the rhythm, whether it's the music at the same time that I'm counting or something, but like, yo, I've done it before. Like it's a thing.
With the same person?
Don't do that. Don't do me like that.
Well, there I feel like they should know that, right? So I want to like one person you might have that chemistry with where you could do that, right? But can you perform like the same way with other people?
Boy. Come on, man.
We're doing this today.
So SB,
he didn't answer that. See, he did it again. I'm gonna keep calling it out.
Yeah, I've done it with more than one person. Mm. So it SB, has worked with more than one person.
Yeah.
Have you been in a situation that is not your proudest moment and haven't had a chance
to redeem yourself? Oh, ooh. Buddy.
So man. When you see that person.
You just get mad? Like you just think about it every single time? You know that
they're thinking about it and they already
that they're thinking about it?
Oh, girls know, man.
I've had that when I
Didn't Priest say how many times girls have their group chat? And they talk.
Yeah, and I hate that part, bro. It's just my thing, but that's the part. It's like, I hate to be that guy in the group chat where they're talking. Like, yo.
I don't really care.
Well, because
things happen. Yeah, I've had that.
Does it happen sometimes? Life just happens sometimes?
Life happens, bro. Life happens. It is what it is. But you have to know yourself well enough to know that that's not you.
Yeah, but what if you don't get the opportunity to redeem yourself?
Yeah, get it with someone else. Make it back up with somebody else? Yeah, it's more about me, the way I see it, right? Like, I would love to have the opportunity to redeem myself, but if it doesn't play out, like, your opinions are hurting me. It's like, yo, I had a one-off. What do you want me to do?
Yeah, but you'll never get it. Well, I mean, not that you'll never get it, but you're kind of like, damn it, I hate that that's just the one experience you have to go off of.
Yeah. Shit happens.
It's happened to you before? Like, you have a couple. Like, how many of those movies you got, though?
Not many. Just one.
Yeah. There's one that just sits with you forever.
Do you have any that sit with you? I don't got any that sit with me.
And then you
try. Hold on. You don't have none that sit with you like that? Oh, Brad.
I would have to really think about it right now. Like, something that just pops up?
Yeah. What are you going to say?
And then when you try to redeem yourself by saying, yeah, next time. Never comes.
Yeah, man, that's the worst, bro.
You got to flip, though, where the other person needs to redeem themselves and you don't give them that chance either. I got some of those, too.
I don't think women see it the same way.
Mm. Valid?
Because speaking with some of them, it's like the expectation is that you're going to do a lot of the work. Where it's like, yo, this is like a half and half thing, like... Don't expect me to put in all of the work.
See, this is what I mean? This is where you need face and the whole horoscope shit. Because, I don't think it's a female-male thing. Because some females are like, yo, I'm putting on a show no matter what.
Exactly.
And then some guys.
But then there are others who are like, yeah, but why would I be the one doing like this? Like, I'm expecting my back to be blown out. It's like, what, you think I'm not going to have something? What's the male term? What's the male equivalent to getting your back blown out?
That's a good question.
Anything? I don't know. What is the male equivalent to getting my back blown out?
Getting my dome blown?
I do think. I do think that some females, till this day, sex is taboo.
For male and female.
So
I think
so. That's why there could be some underperformance on their end.
I think right now is a great time for people to be bluffing more than usual too. Where, like, everybody wants to act like, yo, they got a bag full of tricks or they're about that. And then when it really comes down to that, it's like, not to bring up the whole starfish example again, but it's just like, all right, nah, you are gonna, you know, lead this.
Yeah, a lot of females are still very conservative to where they think these things should only happen in the bedroom. But then some of those ones that believe it should only happen in the bedroom will do some of the craziest things in the bedroom.
Yeah.
Whereas some will be like, yeah, we could be wherever. Backseat of the car, friggin' washroom of whatever.
You think it's more of a Toronto thing? Because I don't think it's like that in the States.
Well, you don't, if what?
I think there's way more like, let's just say freedom.
In the States?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I would guess so and say yes.
I'd almost say it's like a fact.
Because they're not afraid to even have conversations.
Even from like vacations, like you bump into some American girls, yo, it gets to that home run base
they'll
real
slam
quick.
You
like,
same, yeah, they'll slam yeah. you same time and go about yeah. their business, yo. Yeah. It's true still. Yeah, well, I don't know. How did we get here, man?
I don't know. We could keep going.
Oh, yeah, I was going to say, where does this
go? Have y'all had experiences? I already know the answer, but have y'all had experience when the box ain't smelling too fresh, and how do you handle that?
I think it's probably happened to me like once, but it wasn't even that bad, to be honest. It wasn't like horrible.
It's happened to me more than once.
Mm. Yeah, right.
Yeah. One of them just got completely cut. Like, I just couldn't.
Did you, what? You get were it like.
Out. It's like. We're in a small condensed area.
Yo, I don't want to hear about this. Can we change this?
You're the one that.
Like, yeah, this is. I feel like
this is the edit. Vomit, this bro. Is the edit. Yeah, yeah. Because I could. Oh yeah. And it's like
go ahead. I want to hear it.
Yeah, it was just a small condensed place. Like we're in a car, and that car needed the windows down, and like that shit still didn't like stop. Yeah.
I don't do
that. Well, was one of those like. That's what I was saying. Like yo. Do you think they could redeem themselves? Because it's like, I could tell. Yeah, she knew what was going on, and then and I'm just kind of like, I gotta, you know,
damn,
gotta go.
These awkward teenage moments. I mean, not teenage, but like, not as mature as you are now type moments.
Definitely not. But. Odd fact, though.
Would you handle that differently now at this age?
I wouldn't expect it to happen like at this
age. But if
age.
It did?
I don't know how it would happen because it's like more often than not, like you're in the shower, you're not in the backseat of a car, like you actually have a bed in the house or like, you know?
Mm.
The scenario is a little different. Yeah. I don't know what the circumstances would allow that. Having said that, though, fun fact, that's like one of the most common things women Google.
What?
How to make it smell better. Does it smell better?
How do you know this?
A book.
What book is that?
Y'all,
y'all here reading feminine journals? Feminine hygiene journals?
Yo? No.
Ask me the student. Yo. Shout out to book club again.
It's
about data science. I don't remember what the book was called, though.
Data science?
It's about data science. It talks about like people that, what people are Googling in what region. And
that's
stuff
one
like
of the things that females
that was one of the
Google
most common
most.
Things. Yeah. Everybody lies is what it's called. Big data, new data, and what the internet. What? And what the internet can tell us about who we really are. It's a good book, still.
How long ago did you read that? Or is it a listen?
It's a listen. Majority of the time, I'm saying it's a listen. I use it synonymously with it, right? Like, I went through it, I don't know, a couple of years ago, bro. Yeah.
You got more questions or we're good with that?
Yeah, I'm good with that. I don't feel like it's going anywhere.
Okay, I definitely need a female in the room. But I guess a little story I was going to share with you. So my daughter comes to me the other day and she's like, she asked if she can turn the shower on when she's bathing now. And I was like, shower? Like, what? You're that age? Do you remember that age when you started taking showers, like turning on the shower head? Versus just running, standing under the running water?
No.
I remember when it was for me. It was great too.
No, I don't remember.
Not you don't remember? Damn, yo.
I was so used to like the bucket.
up until when?
I don't remember. That's what I'm saying. I don't remember when it switched. I don't remember the switch.
How about you? Do you remember standing in the bathtub type joint still?
I mean, I used to have the water run from the tap.
Yeah.
I would sit down.
But you don't remember when?
Maybe until about 7, 8, 9.
Yeah, so you think 9 years old is when you started turning on the shower head?
It's not a prevalent memory, to tell you the truth.
Damn, yo. I don't remember the day, but I remember how old I was. I was 7 years old. I was in grade 2.
Yeah, no clue.
Damn, yo. Anyway, my daughter came to me on some shower. I was like, yeah, but your hair is going to get wet. And she's like, oh, we can just get a shower cap. Genius idea. I just never thought to myself, I'm like, yeah, I guess that would make sense. But it's not something I'm thinking about in my day to day. You get what I mean? But to hear her just get a shower cap. All right. I guess, I don't know whether she wears one at her mom's house when she's taking a bath or whatever, right?
That just sounds like a thing that she may have seen from her mom.
Exactly. So then watch her now. She's going to bathe now. And she's like, before she goes to bathe, she's like, oh, I went on my tablet and I got the page open so we can look at shower caps after. Yo, bro. Can you imagine, yo?
I could. Yeah, kids are smart. They're advanced, bro. We just think they're like so young because we don't remember being that young. But they know what's up.
So finish bathing now, come back now, we're in the room chilling, takes out a tablet, Amazon. So I had to ask, I'm like, how did you know to go to that? And she's like, I don't know. Like
just boxes at the door.
Just like, exactly.
It's almost a verb these days.
Exactly. Cause I don't think she can even tell when she knew that. Like to go to that website to order these things.
What's the alternative anyway?
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I just, because even online, when you're on the computer, when you're on YouTube, those are the advertisements that you're going to see. That's a little logo in certain places. You're going to pop up in the corner.
Yeah, the tape on the box.
Exactly.
Whenever someone else is talking, hey, just Amazon it.
And she just
get on Amazon.
That's exactly where she went to Amazon.
Not surprised.
To start looking.
Not surprising.
Bro.
Cool. That brand like,
are we already here? Am I already here in life, yo?
We really are, though.
As a father?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's moving a bit too fast, bro.
Nah.
You don't think so?
Nah, I don't think so. I think we look at it as if it's moving so fast because we don't remember that age as well, as to identify ourselves when we were that age.
I feel like I have some pretty vivid memories.
I have some pretty
significant ones.
Yeah.
So I just, I'm very curious as to when she is triggering hers. Like, is this, you've spoken about it before. Mm-hmm. Like, is this a moment that you're going to remember forever? Because we don't know
which one of
these moments they're going to
be. Even the moments that I remember, some of them are so random.
Yeah.
Like, I remember this one thing. This is so random, bro. I'm 5. Mm-hmm. And I bought my mom bought me a fire truck. Like toy and what do you call it? The ladder thing in the toy. Mm-hmm. You could extend it. Like it comes out and it goes even further. Right. Mm-hmm. She's on the phone and I'm telling her, I'm like, yo, look what it does. Like, this is crazy. Like I'm all amped, excited. Right. Mm-hmm. And she gives me this excited response, facial expression, but she's on the phone like, oh wow. Like that. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, yo, she ain't paying attention to me. Mm-hmm. And I remember that specifically. And I'm like, she didn't pay attention to me. She responded to me. I'm going to do this again when she gets off the phone. And I think she's going to recognize it again. So I waited until she got off the phone and I did the same thing again to be like, hey, look what it does. And now she's paying attention to me. Mm. Why do I remember that? I have no idea why I remember that. So
that's interesting to me.
It's so interesting. So to me, it was
because that was a mature move by your stand.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. So I feel like, yo, people, man, that's why I don't, when you said that they're already at this age, I do not overlook it. Because I remember specific memories where I'm like, I still feel like this sometimes. I'm like, yo, you adults dumbed me down. like I was sharp with that sort of stuff. Yeah. So I look at them and the stuff that they say, I don't argue with them. I question them and they're very inquisitive. And I really want to listen to them to understand where they're getting their perceptions from, where they're getting their opinions from, why they're asking certain questions. And we engage in that dialogue. Mm. I see a lot of other parents don't do it like that. I'm not trying to judge the other parents, but I enjoy those moments with these guys.
I had a back and forth with somebody the other day and I was explaining to them, like, I'm conversing with them at all times. And even just by me sticking on the phone with you,
yeah,
that's taking away from my time with them. Because when they're trying to talk to me, I'm trying to listen to you over here. You're trying, like, you get what I mean? Like, there's too much back and forth. So I'm going to focus on just them.
Yeah.
Because I'm constantly, like, in conversation with them, teaching them things, talking about stuff.
Just I'm really hard.
Dissecting everything.
I'm really hard to get a hold of when I'm with them.
Yeah, me too.
It's like, I don't care to really talk to anyone else.
Same way.
And to just see their reasoning behind certain things. I used this example last time too, when like we were watching the fight, me and my son, and to just see what he sees, why he sees it, who won, why they win, like how are you, you know, taking this whole thing in? Mm-hmm. And it's like, yo, these guys are intelligent, man. Like they are at another level with it. I think all kids are like that, engaged enough. And now even getting to like teaching certain children and just seeing how they ask and answer stuff, it's different, man. It's very different. Very, very different.
Another thing my daughter told me this week is that she wants to go to Dubai.
Boom.
Why Dubai? I don't know, but bro.
I know why.
What?
Probably heard me saying it on the podcast.
I mean, she knows. Well, she didn't know that I'd been there once before because she said it.
Mm.
And then I was like, why? Because I've been there before. And she looked at me like, you've been to Dubai before? And I was like, yeah.
Yeah.
But she's like dead set on it. And I wonder if that's even part of my manifestation, because I've told people that if I were 23, 25, if I can go back in time, I'd pick up and leave to go live over there.
Mm.
I mean, I'd been saying that up until last week, because this last week's Dubai isn't this week's Dubai. You get what I mean?
With the floods and stuff that's going on? You didn't see the new updates?
What?
They're like working around that right now. They got little boats for their cars. Yeah,
everything's like good again?
Yeah, it's nuts. I don't know, but everything's good, but they're figuring it out.
But anyways, yeah, she's on this Dubai thing, and I'm like, why do you want to go to Dubai so bad? Yeah. 7 years old, talking about going to Dubai.
Good for her.
Bro. Good luck. Good luck. It's going to be a while before we go over there.
Eh. I mean, it didn't take long for that girl to message you.
That part. I mean, once we get these sponsorship dollars up, you never know.
Only going up this year.
But let's take a quick break and be back with some more perspective after these commercials.
Yeah.
If you're in the GTA and need your car detailed, visit Speckless Pro Auto Detailed. They specialize in both exterior and interior cleaning, including headlight restoration and salt stain removal. Book online at www.specklessprodetailing.com or call 416-262-0702. Don't accept anything less. Visit Speckless. Don't blows not. You're keeping up with this Umar Zameer trial? That what happened over the weekend?
I'm familiar with what's going on. You brought it to my attention.
For anybody outside of Toronto and who's not privy to what's going on, there was a man by the name of Umar Zameer who was on trial facing first-degree murder for killing an undercover police officer. So he's a plainclothes officer. They were looking for somebody in the area involved in a stabbing. And they ran up on Mr. Zameer, his wife, and his child.
She's pregnant when they ran up on
him. And she was also pregnant, yes.
Just for context, first degree murder.
Yeah.
Like, that's, he has the intention to kill.
Exactly. Premeditated thought.
Exactly. Like it's all planned out.
Yeah. So why they were going there with that type of charge in the first place, who knows. But he beat all three charges. Because it was first, second, and then involuntary manslaughter, something like that. Mm-hmm. And he beat all three of those charges. The plainclothes officers ran up on him in a parking garage. He, his wife, and the child were already in the vehicle. And the claim was that he ran over a police officer. The crazy part to this entire thing to me is that these officers who testified all put their story together and all lied. They all sat on the stand and lied.
The stories contradicted themselves. Exactly. There's a lot. There isn't one crazy thing, though. There's a lot of crazy things in this.
Because the guys who did the reconstruction of the incident, they had shown that based off of the reconstruction of the scene, he would not have been standing up and then he hit him and ran him over. He was already on the ground.
Mm.
So it's like, you guys all lied then. So anyways, he goes on to beat all of his charges. Oh, and the other thing too is that when it happened, the media destroyed this guy. Like, he was guilty without even anybody asking this guy two questions.
Yep.
And they roughed him up and everything during the arrest and all of that stuff. Only for the story to play out the way it did. Do you think that they're doing enough to, like, talk? Have you seen a lot of chatter about this? Or
even politicians?
Or do you find that the media has already tried to bury this story now that...
No, I think it's going to get a little bit more fire. Because there's a lot of unanswered questions. It's bringing up a lot of things that are faulty, right? Even with politicians are coming into question, because a lot of them are saying someone that kills a cop shouldn't even get bail because he got out on bail, right? Yeah, yeah. So imagine that.
Doug Ford had spoken about that very early.
Mm.
Like, he was one of the ones who jumped out the gate on some, why is this guy getting bail?
Well, this is why he's getting bail, because he's innocent.
Exactly.
So there's a lot of things that are being tested. Rules and laws that have been, I don't know, I guess existent, but it's like, yo, the scenarios change, things happen, people lie.
But the part that bothers me, and to this day will, is that people are so blinded. These things don't happen. Like, all police officers are just good human beings. They're all here to take care of us. And
even the way he was describing it, because what he was saying is they're banging on my door. They're banging on my windows, and I drove off in the fear of my family.
Exactly, because I don't know who these people are. They could be anybody. Yeah. Like,
they're not dressed. They're undercover.
That's the important part. They're in plain clothes. But not a lot of people have experienced plain clothes officers before.
Communicate.
Have you not? Have plain clothes ever run up on you before? You?
Not run up on me, but I used to bounce at clubs.
Oh, so you would see them every time.
So I was at a St. Patrick's party, and it's got multiple floors. I forget the club now.
Mm-hmm.
And he just flashed me with the badge to be like, yo, let me go on this next floor, because you have to have a different wristband. That was it. So I would have never guessed otherwise. Yeah. Like, that's one example that I can remember. Other than that, it's usually just driving scenarios.
Two times they ran upon me. One time was at my virgin sauce when I told you they pulled the burner on me, the lady cop, plainclothes officer. And the next time when I was at storefront one time and I peeled out of the parking lot, and I was running up the street to go catch some girl I used to talk to who was at the bus stop. They pulled up on me then. And on that time, it was an unmarked vehicle too.
Yeah, that's more
common. Like a green Intrepid or something like that. Yeah, and they had the red flasher on top. They took it out, threw it on top.
Yeah, the Intrepids
and pulled me over. And I was like, yo, who the hell are these guys?
And the Impalas.
Came out in their plain clothes with the badge. And I was like, yo, what?
Yeah.
Where were you guys to be pre-ing me like that?
This is different, though. You got your kid and your pregnant wife.
You're going to react differently.
It's more relatable, the story that's going on.
And a lot of people who haven't been faced with similar circumstances don't know how much your adrenaline hits you and how fast the moment happens. Because it's over before you know it.
For sure.
And you're kind of like, yo, did that really just happen?
Yeah.
Like, how do you know you're going to respond calmly and everything?
Flight.
Exactly. And you're going to do whatever it takes to get out of there.
Yeah.
But for some officers now to lie and say that he was standing there and he ran him over, come on, bro.
But even the Toronto chief, police department.
He wasn't chief at the time, though.
Well, recently, he's disappointed in the verdict.
Yeah.
And he came out and said that.
Yeah.
I'm confused. So again, I'm getting familiar with the whole story as we speak right now, so I don't know if there's missing pieces to the puzzle for me or not. But if the media and a lot of people are standing on one side and suggesting what they're suggesting, and then on top of that, even the judge apologizes to them after the fact that this went to trial, and then after the fact, you're still going on there saying, yo, I'm not pleased with the verdict. Like, is it really over? Isn't that the attitude that we're talking about? That message, I don't agree with it. Again, I'm just getting caught up with everything right now. So if there's pieces of the puzzle that I'm missing, I'm not sure.
That to me just came across like the safe thing to say.
Why? Why is that the safe thing to say?
What else are you supposed to say? We thought it was the right thing to do?
No, don't say anything.
Nah, but there's an expectation.
You disagree with it when everybody is saying, A, your cops look bad because they're lying.
Yeah.
So you're saying, oh, no, we should get away with the lie? Like how are you disagreeing with it? On top of that, the judge apologized to the man.
Yeah.
So the judge said that from very early too.
He's like,
makes you look more
crooked.
You guys
are out here trying to put a first degree murder on this guy. Why are we wasting our time here?
Yeah, so that's what I'm trying to say. It makes him look even more crooked. You're the chief and you're disappointed in the verdict. The judge has apologized. Look at everything that's happening. It just makes you look like you're the wrong person to be in charge right now.
Honestly, bro, I think John Tory saw all of this coming and was like, you know what? Let me just get out of office now because this entire city is about to turn into a shit show.
That's already happening.
That is a real issue, bro.
Yeah, it might be, but that's not.
In your police force, and it became public now, and the only other person that he has to answer to is Mayor Chow. So now, Mayor Chow, what are you going to do about this? We're just going to bury this, act like it never happened so you guys can go back to partying on Thursdays type shit?
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah. But this is the type of stuff that we see in these shows. And it's real. It's real life.
We're getting more and more lucky because of the advancement of technology. So look at all the camera footage that helped this guy.
Yeah.
Right? I'm looking at it, asking myself, how far are we from a dash cam or car manufacturers
already having into the car
legally? Like, you have to have it in there.
Isn't Tesla already practically there? Tesla's, don't they have a camera on you guys?
Tesla's already doing it.
I was going to ask you about the update that just came out the other day too.
I'm all over those updates right now.
And the recall though. You saw the recall
that's
for the
on
trucks?
The Cybertruck side. I'm not there yet.
What anyway,
but my whip's driving right on its own
we
right
can
now.
Get to, we'll get to some of that after.
There ain't much to say about that, but you got that out of me. But how far are we from that? Where... Yo, the dash cam's there, pre-installed.
Bro, that is what the world is becoming, though, even with the glasses.
You seen
those Ray-Bans, yo? Because I'm about to get a pair of those Ray-Bans, yo, with the camera in it.
Yeah.
All day streaming, bro. This is my life. Welcome to my world.
Yeah.
The fuck? You can just always have these things on and recording so people can see your life in real time.
I wonder what the memory on
even
that
my interactions
like.
With the boy them.
Yeah. You know what's interesting? Like, GoPro should be doing something like that. They should be getting involved in that sort of field.
Bro, I already see it now, yo. I'm going to go to Basic Bun to Bun at Night. I'll have my OnlyFans, bro. Keep my glasses on.
Advanced Bun.
What?
Advanced Bun. Basic Bun to Advanced Bun.
Basic Bun to Advanced Bun.
Yeah.
Nah, but I'm over here talking about my experiences, so I'll just keep my glasses on the whole time.
Probably safer that way. Probably safer that way. But I remember
you stream all of that shit, bro.
I remember I was talking about this a while ago.
Nah, you picked up on what I'm saying?
No, I don't get it. What are you trying to say?
Real time porn, bro.
Oh no, I got it. Okay. Yeah. I figured that.
Anyway, what were you gonna say?
I remember I probably brought this up before too. Damon John, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's got the book called The Power of Broke.
Mm-hmm.
And he talks about how he's at this conference with the influencer elites. Like the Gary V's, the Tim Ferris's, and let's just say like 100 of those kind of people, and they have a little get together every year or whatever it is, right?
That's in your future, eh?
I know it is. It has to be. Shout out Damon John, though. He was at the Red Owl conference.
As
a speaker. Yeah, yeah. And I'm a fan. I still have my FUBU jersey still. Mm-hmm. So in that he talks about, among other things, one thing that stands out to me is he's like, they're talking about things like where it's going to be illegal for humans to continue driving, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's in the same realm. It's like from a security perspective, from an insurance perspective, from a safety perspective, everyone should get their little dash cams in there. So like the amount of claims that have been, you know, I guess processed. Yeah.
Yeah.
But in this scenario too, imagine the cameras. Yeah, there's a time where we lived where the cameras weren't up in every corner. Pre-9/11 and all that,
just,
right?
Just me.
So, But I'll take it a whole nother way. Forget all that for a minute. Yo, she was pregnant. Mm-hmm. All right? So this guy missed the birth of his, his son, right? His child.
I didn't even think about that part.
Check this out. You never thought about this either. You know how much potential trauma, the child could be experiencing because now or in the future because of the stress that during that pregnancy?
Had. Yeah.
There's a lot of side effects to that that have been proven. From potential, and I don't wish this, like I hope it's not a thing, but because they were talking about potentially suing.
Yeah.
That'd be pretty good.
As they should. Are you crazy, bro?
Well, it's coming out of our pocket, isn't it?
Well, that part.
So
there's not a GoFundMe to deter
them.
But funny enough, there's a GoFundMe right now to help pay for his legal fees. They were hoping for $200,000. I think last I checked, they're up to $250,000.
Good for him.
Yeah.
Good for the people. Me.
Exactly.
More people need to speak out about this, though. You know, I would love to get more facts. I'm actually happy that you brought this up as a topic.
I'm going to go look for that later and contribute to that, too, you know, because that's like, that's one of those. Because I have my own personal experiences, too, where they ran up on me and on, like, just harassed me on some bullshit. They got some dumb shit. And they, I've had an officer, I've had an officer lie on my name, too.
It's going to be like, you fit the profile.
Bro, there was one night I was out. And they pulled me over and I had a bit of like back and forth to them because I'm not one to hold my tongue for anybody. So
I played sir, a part.
Please.
Somewhat. As a teenager for sure. Yeah. Now I don't have to.
Nah, bro.
I had a weird one. I had a super, super weird one where I'm high school with this girl. We're in the parking lot. She pulls up in her van, I pull up in my car. Okay. Mm-hmm. Having a session. We're not murking it, but like we're just
in the van?
No, in my car.
Why would you choose the car over there?
We're not there yet. We're not banging. We're just making out. And
but why wouldn't you still choose the van over the car though?
I don't know. I like my car.
Right.
A cop pulls up, and this is crazy. I still can't believe this happened. I thought I was so dumbfounded in the moment. Mm. And he's about to write us up a ticket saying, "Okay, so your car was involved in a I don't remember what the incident was now, right? Some sort of incident in a completely different city."
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, that's impossible. It's not even my car. It's my parents' car. They would never be there. I think he's saying like Kitchener. Like back then, Kitchener seemed like what? Seemed like Vancouver. Like, you know what I mean? And I, to your point where they just write up falsified tickets just to meet their quota because they do have a quota. And I was just like, interesting because he could have very well just did that.
So what? He never ended up issuing the ticket?
No, he didn't issue the ticket because... whatever deterred him from it, like I guess finding out that it's my parents' car or whatever. But here's another narrative that I'll give too, outside of the child thing that I said. This could be that subtle racism thing that we're talking about too.
Oh, well, for sure.
Like, are you knocking on everyone's door like that? Or are you aggressively speaking to everybody like that?
Exactly.
Is this still a false narrative or a verdict if someone else is involved? Mm-hmm. And it's further, yo, he should take that speech back, bro, if he's saying that. And I feel like more people need to give this guy an apology. And again, I would be interested to know why. Why is it?
They got a whole why are they not happy? But you've heard this before. There's white, there's black, and there's blue. Once you're in it, you're in it.
There's a bit of a muzzle on a lot of people, though. I can see a lot of police officers not agreeing with that same sentiment that the chief had. Whereas they're like, shouldn't have done that. Yeah, but they're not going to say anything about it. Like, it just stays like, you're part of this gang, you're part of this group, and that's all it is. Yeah. So you're pro, they should sue, eh?
Oh, for sure. Mm. Bro, I'll never forget the time that he ran upon me. My dad lost his mind, bro. My dad wanted to, like, kick all of those police officers' ass.
And you never got your apology either.
Exactly.
From what I recall.
Exactly. Yeah. But the part that the time that I was going to speak to was a totally different time. I'd gone out one night, got back home, and I left. I think I was going to check some girl. Literally pulled out of my driveway, and they pulled up behind me.
Mm.
No lights on, no nothing, and just followed me like around to the other side of the circle. Finally turned the lights on, and by that point I'm like pulling up in front of my brethren's house asking me what I'm doing in a residential area at this time in the morning. Like, how could you be asking me that? Didn't you just see me pull out of the driveway? Because you've been on me ever since. License and registration, blah blah blah.
I don't know what the right word would be. Communications course delivered.
They don't care. They're gonna speak like, to you whichever way they
like,
want.
Like the ego trip, the power trip, it's real.
But hit that button real quick.
Which one?
And not to interrupt you, but blah.
I thought you were done. You're making me go
this
on.
This guy just fully interrupted my story.
And not to like interrupt you, but.
Thought it was the right moment, man.
So I start beaking now. And I'm like, yo, you guys don't have nothing better to do this time of night besides harass me?
Mm.
Do you want me to go get you guys some coffee and donuts?
Mm.
Oh, he got big mad, bro.
That's when he gave you the ticket.
He got big mad. Went back to his car.
Yeah.
came back with a ticket for using a handheld communication device while driving.
Oh, you just gave a little bit more detail to that than the last time. Was this the same time that you were in front of the car parked on your phone, or is this another incident completely?
Which time in front of the car
parked? One time you got that same ticket and you were saying that you were parked.
Yeah, I was parked. Yeah, but I wasn't on my phone. I was parked in front of my friend's house.
You never shared this extra detail.
What part?
With the back and forth that you had with him. So he's like, I'm going to teach you to be a smart ass.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, I asked him if he wants me to go get him a coffee and donuts. Mm. Yeah, him and his partner. It was a female cop that was with him. And I was speaking to her. I was like, yo, like, you want me to go get you guys some coffee and donuts?
Yeah, that's rough.
Came back with a ticket for using a handheld communication device while driving. Meanwhile, I wasn't even moving. But yet, you're a police officer who's supposed to serve and protect, who I'm supposed to feel safe around, but you're going to lie on my name like that?
Come on.
Why am I supposed to trust you?
You know, that's not true.
What? That they're to serve and protect?
Yeah, like that they're like super trustworthy and all that stuff. You know, it's actually, here's another fun fact. They're actually one of the most common occupations where they have affairs.
I think I've heard that before.
I almost feel like I've seen it happening.
Oh, yeah.
Like I'm in my parking spot area about to do whatever, and you see a cop pull up, and then you see a next random cop pull up, and it's gonna be like in the back of the factory, shout out Humberland or something like that, not the Humberland, but like further down on the opposite side, the industrial area. And I'm like, you know what's going on. It's a male and a female, and it's like 2 a.m. Yeah. You're only human.
I mean, from one court case to another, word is Tupac's family ain't happy with Drake using his voice on that song.
Yeah. Apparently it's weaponized. And
I mean,
they don't approve. They don't like how it's used.
My stance is the same. It was very creative.
It was very creative. We're stepping into a whole new world.
Yeah. And I don't, to me, this is just a family reaching at this point.
I'm interested to know who has the rights to Tupac's voice like that, though. Remember, we're having this discussion,
doesn't it just sound wild?
No, not like, really.
Who has the rights to somebody's voice?
It does and it doesn't. We're entering that realm now. And what if it was, I don't know. I don't think it was poorly used. I think it was really artistic and creative. But imagine it's poorly used. Imagine someone used Tupac's voice and like this Biggie again, or is like his family, like I don't know, like
I wonder if these guys are including that in contracts these days though.
What about the pre-existing contracts? What about the people that are deceased like this? So that's what I'm trying to say. So do they even own the rights to this?
Those ones would be hard to figure out, but anybody who's alive now and is signed to some type of a label or distribution company, anything, can you also sign over your rights to your voice then?
Yeah, I think you could. Shout out Snoop with the Speechify?
Yeah.
There must have been something there.
Yeah, some type of licensing agreement.
100%. Yeah, sure. And everyone else on that.
Damn it. How do you get your... Yo. I need to go do some voiceovers, man. Because that's all that it is. I'll license my voice to somebody.
Oh, man. Who are you going to license it to? Yo, what industry would you license it to? Who are you thinking is going to take your voice?
I don't know. What are you thinking?
I'm not thinking nothing. I just think it's funny.
Bang Bros or something?
Well, that's definitely not what I was thinking.
What?
This guy said Bang Bros. This guy just said Bang Bros. Is that even around anymore?
I have no idea.
Nah, it's not around no more. Man. I wish I knew the names. That's not what I'm paying attention to when I'm watching them, though.
The names of who? Like,
you're saying Bang Bros, like the porn media company or whatever. Yeah, I don't know what. I don't think Bang Bros is a thing anymore.
Has your opinion on the song changed at all? Because we're still sitting on your waiting for Kendrick.
Nope. Nothing's changed. I think he's killing it.
Who?
Drake. I think I'm going to go ahead and order an OVO shirt.
Is there still more social media shit that he's throwing out there, though?
The only new thing that's been added is Kanye jumping in and adding his little verse.
It's a waste of time.
Kanye's though?
Yeah, Kanye's a lame.
I don't think so. I think he's smart. This is the time that I think he's smart. So that whole example that I used in the previous episode where I'm like, sometimes he's just crazy, sometimes he's intelligent. This is one of those times where
he's attaching himself to something.
Exactly.
That's like big news in the rap industry.
Exactly. Exactly. His name is now affiliated with that whole thing.
Is this just his way of staying active in the algorithm then?
Regardless of what it is, it's him attaching and upbranding to something that's already happening when he wasn't involved. We never heard his name
for
a minute.
But you see that's all that this was for Rosé, though, right?
That's
Shout all out he Renzel. Could. Yeah, he's hit your
I don't want to knock it anymore. I was gonna make fun of him again, but like he's been doing the same thing. That's what 50 even called him out on that, right? You're more of a Rick Ross kind of guy. I'm more of a 50 kind of guy, right? Yeah, yeah, yeah. So that yep.
That's pretty good, huh? That's pretty good, no?
That wasn't bad. The white boy's better, though. Do the white boy. Do the white boy.
White boy.
When 50's like, he put out an interview like not too long ago. I don't know where I heard it. He's like, I know what Ross is doing when he brings my name in, right? Mm. He wants to associate me with whatever he's got. Ross has actually said this too. He's like, often I do it purposely when I have something to push, some sort of product to push. But he does it like, it's not as creative. Like, it doesn't seem as authentic.
But
you know?
Do you see how so much of it stems from beef, though? Do you see how much the beef sells? Nats, do you see it too? And this is kind
of. It's not just that.
But this goes back to my whole point when it comes to like, even us as Canadians. Mm. Canadians don't beef like that to big up our thing. You get what I mean?
We don't have enough people to beef like that.
You don't think so?
It's not about it being real beef. What's your definition of real beef?
That's what I mean. We make it big enough because we make it entertaining for people to then want to listen and tap in to catch up and see what's going on.
It's got to be some sort of Canadian beefs out there like that that we just can't think of. Well, I guess The Weeknd and Drake got their little thing going on.
But this is why I keep saying I think some of that is just manufactured beef.
I don't think it's manufactured beef. Right. I think it's to use it when it's already happening to benefit yourself. That's what it is.
Right.
Yeah. And a great example of that is what Garcia is doing right now.
I feel like you're moving too fast, bro.
That's too fast? That was like the perfect segue. What else you got to say about the beefs?
We don't talk about regress. And you respect his video?
No, I like the idea that he's, like, the way that he's using it. All right, 2 hours, let me get involved in this, let me take some light away. But, that's it. Then you got a couple of videos saying, white boy, respond to me, and you just got ignored. So it's like, it's over for him. He needs a bigger shock value to do something now to actually have that light stay on him. Whereas I think Kanye will.
He needs some nudes to be leaked or something.
He needs something. Like it died down so quickly for him. Yeah, it died down real quick for him. It might die down for Kanye too, whereas he might do a couple more interviews. People want to hear Kanye more. I think his following's larger too. It's just different. Yeah. It's just there's levels to it. I feel like Ross took more of an L doing that because he kept going with that whole thing. And he just got made fun of. Ross brings him up constantly.
Yeah.
Like his plan has just become so obvious now. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And 50's like, I can't even keep up with you. Like, I've already buried you, destroyed you, done all this other stuff.
You think Ross identifies 50 as like the gold model though?
Yes, dude. You might not say it out loud, but you have to. Who doesn't? Who doesn't?
Jay?
Maybe. Maybe.
Nas?
Yeah.
Or you think 50 is up, he surpassed Nas at this point?
In terms of what? It's a different kind of conversation.
The setup, like his business ventures.
Oh, for sure. That's not even like, Nas isn't as open about the stuff that he's got going on.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So it's harder to see what's going on. Like he just, he's got something going on with some casino that's opening up right now. I think it's opening up in that, like somewhere in New York around that area, but he doesn't talk about where he's getting his money. And the truth is, I don't think 50 lets you know how much money he's got either. He keeps a lot of stuff undercovers. Whereas some people want you to know. P. Diddy wants you to know. Yeah, I'm a billionaire. Like he wants to have that. Jay sort of too wants you to know how much money he's got. Kanye in a way too wants you to know how much money he's got. A lot of these guys don't want you to know how much money they have. They just want to keep that to themselves and you just watch me. Just watch everything that I got going on. Has he surpassed him? Yeah, I guess in certain categories easily. Just depends what we're looking at.
Did you just throw yourself up so you can just see yourself? Like a reaction shot?
No. I accidentally pressed 4.
Bullshit, yo.
Get that camera time, bro.
What?
Get that camera time.
That's hilarious, man. Where's my phone, man? I guess nothing. I guess Ross is taken care of.
Yeah, that died down so quickly. Unless they're, imagine, like, here's one thing that could happen that would be big.
What?
Since we're calling all these guys the Avengers, if they really do come together and put out a track, all of them.
That could never happen.
Why
not?
That'd
be very lame.
Maybe. But why would it be lame? It's happened before.
On what?
When they took down Jaw.
Oh, New York?
With no.
Jada, Fat Joe, and... Oh, no, that was Ja Rule's song. My bad.
No. When DMX is on it, Eminem's on it, Busta's on it. I forget what it's called. It did happen, though.
What did you say?
It's Hail Mary that you're thinking of.
This song?
50 and Eminem.
Yeah, I remember this song. This is Busta Rhymes. I remember this. I had it on... I had it on one of my Dippy's mixtapes. Oh, I remember this one. This one rap was like it.
It was it like a week ago.
Exactly. Now Kendrick's over here moving like a lame.
Is Kendrick not responding? Is he being lackadaisical? Or is Kendrick cooking up something artistic?
Like what?
It doesn't matter. It's slowly getting to a point where I don't care anymore.
Exactly.
Yeah, well, I heard rumors that his album may drop
in May.
Yeah. Cares. Could he do something creative like the, you know, the Heart, you know, the Heart music video where he did the deep fake faces,
yeah.
Right? So could he do something creative with along Drake? That lines to speak to
and then
this entire can, situation?
Then can Drake sue him?
No, Jeez. I kind of like that take because imagine Kendrick did that whole face shit again, but he turns into Drake. Imagine it turns into different people from Drake's lives that we've been introduced to. Because we know what Drake's dad looks like. We know what Drake's mom looks like. We know what his son looks like. We know what his girl looks like.
I don't remember.
Imagine Kendrick gave the man one of those and he just raps from different perspectives.
That'd be dope.
Ooh.
That'd be dope.
And he would do that. Ooh. Or he is creative enough to do that.
My perspective may differ from yours.
Yeah, whose team are you on?
I don't know. I'm starting to switch sides, bro.
Yeah, that could be a good angle. That could be a very good angle.
That's I like that take, bro.
They were talking about
because he's proven that he has the capabilities.
Yeah. That'd be cool. Give the visual.
But the thing is, Drake just did that with the whole Pac and Snoop thing.
It's not the same,
exactly. Because I think Kendrick's like the master of that, bro. And even though Drake had to use the AI voices, Kendrick could make it lyrically disgusting just using his own voice and just like his flow, his rap, his everything.
You think someone pulled? You think someone called something in? You think that's real?
What
the
AI shit?
No, the family not approving and all that stuff. Like, you think they really cared, or you think someone said like, "Yo, you're gonna let him do that"? What's so like? You know what I mean? Like,
I can see people in the family having issues with it. Like with this, who it's his brother. We're saying,
yeah,
that was the report.
Yeah,
like that's not to say that his aunt or somebody else in the family may not care and maybe looking at him like, why are you chasing that? Just dead it. Like, who cares? It's not that serious. What?
What I'm saying is, you think there's people that are in the circle that are saying like, yo, you shouldn't let him do this. Like,
in
it's an
circle?
Outside influence.
Who? Like who?
I don't know, someone from the West. Someone from maybe what's his face?
Like Ice Cube or something?
No,
C,
no, no.
What?
No. Someone from like that's close, like not even music related. Shug did say something about it. I didn't get a chance to read that though. But whoever is I wish I caught what he said. Because he's been talking a lot from behind bars. Yeah. He might be talking more than anyone I know from behind bars.
Shug did
say something. Dude's got a fucking podcast, bro. You that's know. That's nuts. If you really break that whole perspective down. Oh, man. Anyway, I don't know. I meant more like just the culture, someone on the West Side where they're like, yo, speak up about this. But again, I don't really care anymore. The excitement's dying down. It would have been cool if it was back and forth.
Exactly. But now,
like, yo, we're approaching the end of April now.
But I'm not mad at it if Kendrick is literally cooking something up that is that good.
It's back to our conversation from last week. It's got to be that high level, like explosive shot.
It's either that,
like a bazooka or a nuke or a missile or something.
What if he turns it into an EP, like a 5-track EP, and every one of those songs is from like a different perspective, getting at Drake or something?
That'd be pretty sick. That'd be sick. It's never been done.
Like if you turn it into
like yo, here's an album. Shooting shots,
but it can't be like a 14-track album. It has to be like a 5-track EP type shit.
Sure,
Like what?
That'd be
like
pretty sick.
Meek just released a 5-pack. You know, it's a really good 5-pack.
Yeah.
So if Kendrick did something like that, where it's like
Kanye was trying to get everyone to do that for a while on Good Music.
5-packs?
No, a little more. I think it was 7 or 9 tracks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's all you really need, yo. He's to be honest.
Well, it makes sense right now with the way.
Yeah, the current state of music, the way, how fast it moves. You don't need to put out 12. Like, for me to go through 12 of your songs, bro, it's like, that's for dedicated fans. Like, what Taylor Swift just did, what Beyonce recently did. Anybody who's doing these, like, 20-pack albums, bro, those are your dedicated fans, the ones that you know are going to go listen. And they have a big enough audience to where they know their core is in the millions. If you're 6th, 7th place rapper, shout out Big Sean out here, you can just stick to those 5-packs, bro.
He might have moved up.
No full albums out. It's like,
might have moved up.
You'd be like, not to punk him, but I just mean from that era.
Yeah.
Like, it's hard for you to keep up, bro. So it's like, switch it up. Do what Meek just did. And I'm telling you, Meek's 5-pack was a really nice 5-pack, bro. That EP that he dropped was really good songs.
I probably listen to more Meek than I do the rest of these guys, as it is, to be honest with you.
Yeah. But if Kendrick were to be doing that right now, that'd be interesting.
There's so many.
Again, it's like nobody's ever done that.
You know what? Let's play with this.
What
else can Kendrick do creatively for this to be awesome? Like, you've given two pretty good ideas. If he did the whole visual thing like he did in that video, that'd be sick.
It'd have to be something like, imagine one track was dedicated to like how he would kill Drake. Like, imagine
a little extreme, but I get what you're saying.
But no, I mean, like, but Kendrick has that musical talent, that ability to literally, like, almost like Nas talking about like anything. We've heard Nas talking about shooting a gun.
Yeah.
You get what I mean? So imagine Kendrick gave us one of those. That's a diss track, but from a different lens that we are not necessarily thinking.
That would have to be added to a direct, realistic response first.
To what? To everything.
Like, you can't come up with a fictional track right now.
No,
that doesn't hold weight.
I'm not sure I'm explaining this right. So in my head now, try to follow along. Imagine Kendrick created a diss track where he's talking about wanting to literally kill Drake in the diss track, but dissing Drake at the same time.
No, I get it. But what do you mean? Okay, so when you add in the part about and dissing Drake at the same time, what does that mean? I'm talking about context. Like, he's got to have bars in there that's actually like taking shots at
who
Drake
what I mean.
Is as a character.
Yes, that's what I mean.
And then tie it into how I'm going to kill him?
Yeah.
Okay, I don't know. Like, what, maybe the hook? How I'm going to... I don't know. I don't see those two things going together. It wouldn't level up. It'd be like, there's a bit of fiction in this because you're not going to kill him. Like, you're acting a part.
Yeah, but that's just part of making creative, though.
I think those two things would have to be two separate... They would have to be two separate things.
Why?
Kind of like what Drake just did right now.
Because one thing is dumb it down?
No. When you're going at somebody, from my understanding of how a rap battle or a diss track should be, yo, go, like... The truth will give you more points. Like, you're actually bringing up stuff that's really happening or happened or is factual versus just coming up with a story of
and you don't something think Kendrick has the lyrical ability to do that.
I'm not saying he doesn't have the lyrical ability. I'm just saying it wouldn't be the greatest mixture of things, because it'd be like you want to give him points because, yo, you're on point with that. But then it's like, yo, you're not going to do that. What are you talking about? So it should be two separate things. Like, imagine Drake did what he just did right now on the initial diss.
it's two great ideas,
but he separated them.
I can see that happening where maybe one track on the album is just one of those responses, and another one would be like
it would have to
a creative that, track where he's doing something else.
Yeah, in my opinion, that makes way more sense.
Would you be there for it though? You'd go listen to all 5 of those tracks?
But when are we getting this in like June? Like,
hey man, art takes time, bro.
I guess, but yeah, look how programmed we are. Like,
what?
Like
not
I,
you're
I,
there for it?
I need instant gratification right now. I need to see this ASAP. I'm still gonna dig into it when it comes out, but the excitement's, you know, going away. I'm slowly starting to say, eh.
Yeah, but then that's when you get the best effect, yo.
Maybe.
When they're least expecting it.
The way that I took Taylor Made was basically him saying Drake saying, yo, you don't even call shots right now. You got to sit back for a minute by your record label because Taylor's putting out her own thing right now. I don't even know if they're on the same record label. I just assume they are.
Who are you talking about?
That's what I took from what Drake was saying on Taylor Made.
Yeah.
So he's basically saying, you can't even pull the string to pull it out right now if you wanted to. And then a part of it. And then also, yo, you're sitting in New York, whatever, coming up with something. Like, how deep does this run? Like, what is he really asking himself too, like, what can I come up with right now to have the same impact or to fire a shot that's heard or that allows me to continue to the next round? Like, at this point, the more we keep having these discussions, because everyone else is having these discussions too, it's like, yo, what more can he do right now? Because the more this clock ticks, the bigger and more creative this thing has to be, no?
Tick, 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 tick. Your boy is sick, 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 sick.
Yeah.
I don't know.
What else could he do? What else could he do that's creative?
I was right there with you up until a couple of days ago. I'm like, yo, I don't put it past Kendrick to be doing some, I don't know, man, some shit, bro.
So this is what, like, I was saying. That's what I was trying to say before you said that.
Imagine this guy could create like some We Are the World shit.
Well, that's what I was trying to say.
On some Quincy Jones level where he got like everybody in the rap game. So, oh, you're on one big track.
Yeah, you just took away what I was saying initially.
Like, I'm like, in my head, I'm thinking banned from TV, 2024, and it's a diss track at Drake. Can you imagine, bro?
That's what I just said, and you're like, they can't do that. And then we went into the whole thing about Eminem.
What, last week or this week?
Right now, like less than an hour ago.
Where I'm saying, I can't see Kendrick doing that, but it's just, imagine. I don't know, it makes no sense. I don't know. I don't know, this entire shit makes sense to me at this point. Kendrick, fuck.
Yeah, you just went in like an interesting circle there, like in real time. Like, I can't even imagine, but you're imagining it. Anyway. Yeah. That's about it. What else could he come up with that's so creative? That he puts out a 3D video?
All of that extra shit they did, it's unnecessary.
It's necessary.
Fuck that. I'm back in my original position. Kendrick needs to hurry up, bro.
Yeah.
Like, this is, like, it's whack. Saturday can't pass and you didn't put nothing out.
I think, let's put him, like, for fun. When do you think he will actually have something? If you have to bet a date, you know how people have to guess people's, I don't know, when the kid's going to be born or whatever? Yeah. Well, put a date on it. Because he likes to play with numbers and shit too, right?
Like, does that he?
Doesn't he? Yeah, like he put out, like he had this one line about,
where
I'm way different from blah, blah, blah. And that was like X amount of time ago where he talks about a song and then he's cutting it in half and
using that part. I don't either.
I just hear some of these guys that talk about it, but
I don't follow these guys enough. I'm giving him the 27th of April.
So 3 more days? I wonder if that's,
I mean, depends on when this gets out, but 27th of April?
Well, yeah. What is it today?
24th. I say Saturday because we've been getting these things on Saturdays. Or have Friday.
No,
Friday,
we got it on Friday. Saturday. That's what I was going to say.
The Future one was a Friday night release music. And then the Drake was a Saturday drop. Was it?
I think we're going to get
it late Friday night?
I think we're going to get it this Friday.
Well, I guess they were Friday nights. So I guess they were Friday
nights. If I have to predict, I'm going to go with the 26th. I say we get it this Friday.
I'm trying to think what 26 might be in numerology or...
I couldn't go that far. But
yeah, or who did anybody die on the 26th of April? Like, you know, one of those ones?
Yeah, like it's got... Oh, wait, hold on. That's actually not a bad one.
What?
I don't know, something like that. Like are we giving him too much credit? What if he sits there like, yo, shit, I got nothing. Where's AI? Like,
bro. I mean, if I were him, I would have went back to that AI track that came out, yo, because that one was pretty good.
Yeah. Not good enough. Let's dead this.
Yeah, but how?
Hit that button. What if his response is just super trash? What if when he comes out with it, it's just super trash?
I think we'll all just be disappointed and Drake would have just, at that point, he'll be crowned.
Does Drake still have to shoot another shot?
Nah.
Does Cole move up again?
Nah. What Drake does is go back to everybody else now. That's when Future's going to get his. That's when Ross might get another one. Ross maybe not get another one, but I feel like Drake might just every few tracks he does, throw a bar in there for him.
He took one at Pusha too, and no one really brought it up.
Which one?
When he's like, you got, I guess N-word, making a whole career off my son.
I like how this guy had to throw the N-word in there.
Yeah. So when he goes back at everyone else, right?
Yeah.
He goes back at Pusha too?
Nah.
Why? Because he respects him.
Yeah, I think he took that one and just gonna dead it. Mm. I wouldn't go back to that.
That's what could steal the show right now.
What?
Like Push us probably.
If Push came out.
If he came out right now and he just sprayed the block, I'm listening. He's the right guy to make a move right now. I need to be his PR. Like,
I'm not mad at that take, you know.
Yeah, he could be the guy that takes the light. Like, he could pull the Kanye. Like, Kanye, if they're still on the same record label, because I don't think they are, he could be the guy to take it and reignite that whole thing.
But like, how would Push get into it?
I have no idea, but we know him for what he already did. So it would be like maybe part two to that.
I think if I'm Push, I'm coming out on some Kendrick shit.
He could take the Ross, light.
Like, Ross, you tried. You got, like, stiff-armed.
He won't
Metro
do that.
Metro Boomin.
He won't do that to Ross. Well, him and Ross are cool. Like, he won't do that.
So, you're just going to solely go at Drake then?
That's how I would see it.
And say, what, Pussy, you couldn't even come back to me, but now you're firing shots at all
something
these people?
Something like that. Because when they had the back and forth and he had his interview, right, he said some interesting stuff. He's like, Drake called up my neighborhood and tried to get information on me. And he's like, I got it all recorded. I got it on tapes.
Are you serious?
Oh, yeah.
Nas, you heard this before?
Yeah, so there you go. Okay. So that level of strategy to think that far, to have those tapes, all that stuff, and apparently, like, Drake was paying them and stuff. It's all allegedly, but this is what he was saying. I'm like, wow, that's impressive. Like, I became a bit more of a fan at that point. And this is pre-Daytona as well. Daytona was amazing. So he could be the guy right now to do something, I feel. Or, to your point, Kendrick shoots back with the perspective of Pusha too on one of those albums. He shoots back for everybody. What? Tell me that wouldn't be sick. He puts on the Future face. He shoots back. He puts on the Metro Boomin face. He shoots back. Does the Ross shoots back. Yo, he just goes off. Even goes back to like Joe Budden and everybody.
Oh. Like,
goes off. That would be pretty fucking crazy.
Because imagine if he got everybody's story lens as to why they have an issue with this one guy.
But check this out.
And then he puts together the bars based off of what they share with him.
Yo!
Heart part six.
Check this out. Yo, but he would he would be knocking all of them too. Because he'd be like, yo, I just shot him on for you guys. I'm better than all of you because you couldn't say this.
The heart part six.
That would be fucking crazy.
Heart part six. That's what I'm calling the heart. Because he has six versions of the
heart. I was just going to No, he has five.
God damn.
He has five. He has five. Yeah, this would be the sixth one. So this is going to be the sixth one.
This could be the sixth one. Six.
Yeah, six. Yeah, I know. Toronto. Six. Yeah, of course. Yeah, Toronto. Six. Yeah. You think we just figured it out?
You looked at me like you're going to say kid again.
What? Nah. We figured it all out, eh?
If he does that, that'd be... Yo.
My perspective may differ from yours.
Yo. That would be exciting. That six. I would forget all about the time. I'd forget completely.
Part six.
Yeah, we prophesied last week, eh? So
that is true. This might just be the call that we get in the next little while. Like kind of like what happened last time.
Part six.
My God, we're not even from the States, bro. Jeez, you guys need to start calling us out there and giving us real information. This is just us and our imagination. Shout out Rexdale.
Yo, that might be it, yo. I really think it might be the hard part six.
But do you get what I mean? By he would be knocking he'd be knocking his fellow rappers at the same time. Cause he's basically he could even shoot back from a Cole perspective.
Yeah, I'm scared, eh?
That'd be like, so crazy.
I'm getting kind of nervous.
That would be so crazy.
Toronto might we might be in for something at this point.
You've been writing more bars?
Nah. You know what I mean? Don't check.
I'm not gonna lie though,
oh man, this is it.
I'm not gonna lie.
This is our viral moment, guys.
I'm not gonna lie. Your bars kind of inspired some ideas for me. If I was Kendrick,
Oh, let's hear it. You got a beat.
But if I was Kendrick,
yeah,
I would put out a promo. And use a Quiet Storm Mob Deep instrumental.
They just use it on Futures. They just use that beat. I thought if I was Kendrick, I'm going to draw for Ether. Like a new age version of Ether.
Thank you. You just kind of admitted
exactly what I'd be going to.
I don't blame you.
Because the second you hear that pop, 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 brrr, you're going to know what time it is, bro. Mm. But it have like a West Coast like flavor to it almost.
It's got to represent them. It's got to be hard like Ether was.
Brady, imagine Nas was on there with him. Now we're going too far. We're going
way too far.
I'm just saying, with all these things that are happening,
if you want to say that, then what, Jay and Drake come back at them? Like,
honestly, bro, that wouldn't be sick. That wouldn't be sick.
Oh my god,
no, that wouldn't be sick.
I don't know where I'd want. I'd have to switch sides.
But that is some WWF type bullshit, bro. That's what it is, yo. That would get everybody going.
But that's not hip hop culture. WWE is not authentic. That shit is scripted like that, right? So,
but it sells, yo. Yeah. It sells.
So does being authentic.
Alright.
I don't even think this is about sales right now. It's not always about sales. It's really not.
I know it's not, but
talk to Mos Def.
Okay, from that perspective, I see what you're talking about.
Loving these skews.
Maybe that could be another face that he puts on too. Response from Mos Def too.
What?
And Common? Everybody, yo. There's so many faces that he could respond for. He could even put on faces for people that want to respond that have no balls to respond. Nav, it could be dirty. Yo, Nav, the weekend.
Nav ain't there yet, bro.
Like, yeah, he's really not. He's really not.
Shout out Rexdale, though. Run, sir. Max said you sus the runs, bro.
Only going up this year.
Like, you said it so fast, I ended up getting excited and seeing it too. And that's an edit. Man, that'd be dope. Even who's the guys that he's got beef with from the NBA? He gives their perspective.
Oh, John Morant.
Yeah, I'm overdoing it now. But you get it. You get it. Yeah, does one for Rihanna too. Oh man, does one for Meek. Oh my god, like,
yo, the heart part.
That would be sick. That would be sick. You take the top five. You take.
Calling it.
Man,
the heart part six.
I can't stop thinking about this idea.
Speaking from the heart's
perspective. I need some contracts for my ideas, bro.
Yeah, but I'm trying to think. Like, when does he drop it though?
Because now
in terms of math, I'm like, yo, the sixth month is June, which isn't that far away.
Listen.
And when you think about it, June ain't that far away.
Okay.
June 6th is a Thursday.
Yo, Kendrick, reach out to SUP on IG. We'll give you some ideas of what you can do, all right? The talent part of it will be on you, but we'll give you amazing ideas.
I'm not going against the boy.
Hold on. And once that's done, Drake, yo, link us. We'll get you the fire back. We'll come up with the next one.
My World maybe Series thing wasn't...
Maybe he performs at the Sphere.
What are you pulling up, Nat?
I'm just trying to see if there's any information of his new album coming out.
Oh, nah. He don't put that stuff out. That's just going to drop.
I can't believe how excited I got about this idea.
Yeah, I think Nats really had that. The hard part six. I think that's what it is.
All right, well, it's going to have to be. This is the viral moment, boys. Get excited. What if Drake starts shooting back at us now? What if we become targets?
Hey, man.
Only going up this year.
Imagine you get a contract because of your bars.
Hey, man.
Only going up this year.
Oh man, we find out that you're your lazy jaws ghostwriter. Oh man.
Anyways, on that note,
you're the one that's talking about beef cell.
But it's been proven.
Oh man. All right.
But we'll take one more break. And I want to go back to that whole Tesla shit real quick. Are you looking to refinance this year? Make home improvements? Need a new mortgage? No problem. If you are in the GTA, don't wait. Book a one-on-one consultation with Suresh Ravindran at 416-953-8073. Know all the options available to you.
Half a million on a couple of jewels and I ain't even wearing the shit. You block out a chain and I heard a couple of niggas is sharing the shit.
Say what?
Gucci's got a video right now.
About what?
Where he's got a chain sing the daddy, and he's like he's got someone else pretending to be big.
What are you talking about?
Axe got it on his fucking story. Gucci's got a tracker. I like Gucci still.
I mean, yeah, well, I don't hate Gucci. I was never big on Gucci back in the day.
I got into him when he put out the diss track to Young Jeezy. That was just fucking crazy. That was probably one of the most disrespectful diss records.
Yeah, it was too. but I mean, going from beef outside of the ring to actual beef inside of the ring, real or not, you watched that Garcia fight?
I didn't watch the fight.
But you saw the highlights and shit?
Yeah, yeah.
As soon as you're right in your take.
Facts. we need a button for when I like, when I.
Winner. Bingo. Bingo.
There you go. There you go. I knew he was going to be stronger. And like, I wasn't 100% sure of his speed in comparison, but I knew, I know he's got a combination of strength and speed, right? Mm. What turned me off was that he didn't make weight. So as soon as I heard that, I'm like, oh, he's winning for sure now. Like, now there's really no doubt.
Yeah.
3 pounds over makes a big difference, bro. A lot of people keep talking about that, like, oh, it's only 3 pounds and whatever, whatever. Nah, that's a lot. And especially when a lot of the weight is water weight, because majority of the weight when you're losing weight,
it's water weight.
Yeah, but it's coming out of, like, your head, like, you know what I mean? Like, the water's coming, yeah, more from your head, like your brain, that whole area. And then when you rehydrate, that's the last place to get the hydration. So those punches could be dropping him just because of the water weight that he lost. Like, he's weaker at that point. You know what I mean? Mm. Haney? And then same thing Ryan was talking about when he fought Tank. You know, we're in Atlanta when we watched that fight, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So he was like, I won't go back to that weight class again, but I'll fight Tank again. And he even said Haney would beat Tank.
Isn't that who he wants right now?
He goes and fits at his weight class right now.
But that is who he's firing shots back at now. Like, I want you next. It's Tank, isn't it?
He goes, if I'm not dropping down to your division. I think he's at 135. He's like, I'm not dropping down to fight you. You got to move up and fight me here. Yeah. So he's like, I'm open to that. But he's got a whole bunch of other fights lined up. They keep teasing this thing with Sugar Sean O'Malley, too, from UFC. Mm. He's like, oh, I'll come to the UFC, tell Dana I'll fight him, rah, rah, rah. I don't see that happening. But, crazier things have happened, I guess.
I know a lot of people that lost their money on the weekend, though. I can tell you that much.
Yo, shout out to Patrick Bet David. I'm starting to watch his podcast a little bit more now. Mm. And he had an interview with him. With
Garcia?
Yeah. Did you, like, keep up with the stuff about Garcia prior to the fight? Like, what, the crazy bullshit antics that he was doing?
A little bit.
A little bit? Like what do you recall that he did?
I just heard the biggest one was him talking, like, the bullshit, but he's going to sue Haney for hitting him because he identifies as a female.
Nah, he did way crazier shit before that. So he was even being asked after the fact. So Patrick McDavid was like, yo, how do you top this now? Now what are you going to do? He's like, I don't know. Like, maybe I have to go crazier next time, or maybe I just have to not do it at all. My point really is, it's interesting that you could actually make Vegas switch the odds on things like this. And have the crowd believe, like, at one point I was kind of thinking, like, yo, this guy is a bit crazy. Now the next part of it is, he's like, these rumors are actually true about this place and child trafficking and all that stuff, right? And the elites being there, and he's like, they're gonna take this to Congress. But the flip of that is, now, yo, when do I believe you now? like do you just become this guy that's untrustworthy?
But do you think he cares if he's making millions of dollars?
I don't think he does. Yeah, I don't think he does. But he said a lot of interesting things in that, too. And it's another one that we've been talking back and forth, because even related to what Kanye is saying about Drake right now, where certain people are just owned and they're bought, and, like, you just don't say certain things. So he's going at Logan Paul and KSI, and they're Drake Prime.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't hear about this at all.
Yeah. So he's like, well, Prime sells a lot.
Yeah.
Like, a lot. Like, it's estimated, like, something billion. And KSI, Logan each have like 20% of it, right? Mm-hmm. But I guess I'll say this too. Allegedly, there's a lot of case lawsuits against them, and like the effects that it's having on kids and stuff like that. And apparently they had seizures or something like that. Mm-hmm. So he's like, I'm coming up with a drink now, and I'm going to make sure that company goes under. It goes bankrupt, blah, 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 whatever, right? So he's bringing that up. He's making that next move now. He's pushing that next thing now that he's got all these eyes. Mm-hmm. So one was setting up the fight. The next was performing at the fight. Mm. Now it's like, what's that next agenda that I'm pushing? Mm. So he's showing a lot of brains behind everything in the way that he's navigating this whole thing, right? it's just become business now. Like I don't remember where I read this, but they say you might not be the best person at making mugs.
Yeah.
Okay. However, maybe you make the most creative mugs in your videos. Like, so you make the mug and you sing a song while you do it. How many people are singing a song and making a mug? I'm just making up some random example, right? So now you have like these two skill sets that you could even be average at, but you combine them together and now you're the best at that. That's what this is becoming. So he might not be the best marketer, but he's a really good boxer and he could do all these other things to navigate the attention. So he's doing them together now to put these packages together and sell them. Sort of like what Jake Paul really did as well. He's not the greatest boxer, but he knows how to market really well and get your attention. So as he's getting your attention, he's able to sell you whatever it is that he's selling you. And I'm purposely saying Jake Paul because he's been able to get a lot of big fights. Example, the Tyson one that's coming up right now, right? Logan Paul, same thing. All right, so I'm selling this drink to this audience. I'm able to get Mayweather in the ring. I'm also able to go jump in WWE and do their whole thing and be on WrestleMania and all that. So look at the type of marketing that they're doing and I guess taking advantage of your physicality, right? Do you follow Patrick Bate David at all?
No.
I'm starting to get more and more into him, but shout out to his books too.
You're not in your head over there.
Yeah.
Say what?
Yeah, for years now.
There's certain things that he talked about that I felt like, in my opinion, Ryan already does really well. Maybe he's read them or he's followed them or something like that because he started. Actually, Dame was on there not too long ago either. Dame had some interesting things to say about him, but that's a whole other conversation. Your Next Five Moves, super dope book. And then Choose Your Enemies Wisely. That was another good one, right? The Choose Your Enemies Wisely is the one that recently came out. But this also adds to what we're talking about, Kanye, and we're just having that brief conversation before. He's trying to attach himself to what's going on right now. Who else in hip-hop right now that's relevant, and I don't even want to just say hip-hop, let's just say artists in general, can he attach himself to further develop his stardom and his musical craft? You get what I'm saying? So Drake's definitely the guy. And every so often, he could still bring up Taylor Swift because of their incidents.
Honestly, that's exactly where I was going.
Yeah. Taylor Swift. And then he's also involved in that whole situation with Beyonce.
I knew exactly. Yeah, I know.
So he, you know what I mean? Yeah, so choose your enemies wisely and then know when to get rid of them. So 50 is a good guy to use that example for, to get rid of your enemies. So you're at this level. You already bodied these guys. You'll move on. You're almost wasting your own time staying there.
I wonder why it didn't work for Lil Mama, though.
What else could she add to
that? When she ran on stage with Jay-Z and Alicia Keys?
What else is there?
There hasn't been anything since then. You need the follow-up.
You definitely need the follow-up. You definitely need the follow-up.
Damn, yo. Shout out to Lil Mom wherever she's at, yo.
Yeah. But one of the main things that he was really saying that I liked about the book was how much they emphasize getting to know yourself. And then he's got a bunch of these quotes. I'll read a couple off real quick. And this is so relevant to what we're talking about too, actually. Coincidentally, study the most important product, you. Become who you are by learning who you are. And that's by Pindar, like a ancient Greek poet. It seems so basic, but a lot of these poets and philosophers and all that stuff, that's all they would preach. Yogis, right. Meditators, like, yo, get to know yourself better, man. Like, really understand yourself. Another one, I don't even know who wrote this, but who this quote's by, but I just jotted down a couple of them. And this is true too. How do you feel about this, by the way? Knowing yourself is like one of the hardest things that you could do.
Yeah.
You get that?
Yeah, for sure.
There's so many layers there with it. Yeah.
I mean, the biggest one for me that I just will forever sit, and I have been in my Earl Nightingale bag as of late too, is you are what you think about. You become what you think about.
That's a fact.
Yeah. It's just it boils all the way down to that.
Yeah.
You become what you think about.
He goes through that a lot in the first book, Plan Your Next Five Moves. Mm-hmm. So anybody that's looking to open up a business, both those books would be good. But a big part of what he says is like just figuring out what you really want for yourself. You know what I mean? And then he'll ask you certain questions where you really got to authentically check yourself. Like, is this something that I want to do, continue to do? Like, who do you want to be?
Yeah.
When you ask someone, who do you want to be? You could probably knock that out.
As opposed to what do you want to do?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's who you want to be.
And it's like,
that's how you develop your habits.
what matters to you most,
yeah.
and at what level are you willing to make a commitment and consistently follow it along with a strategy.
Yeah.
And then he also brings into like, you know, logic is one thing, and then adding in emotions is another. Mm. And they got to go together. You can't just be coming up with the plan, but you're not, you know, you're not passionate about it. A lot of basic things, the way that I'm saying it right now, but he goes in depth.
Only going up this year.
Before we go, though, I wanted to speak to Tesla real quick, yo. They have to recall 4,000 of their Cybertrucks. That can't be good for those guys, yo.
That's rough.
How's the update going?
The update's incredible.
Help me understand this. What changes when they do an update on their cars, their vehicles?
Every update is different.
And what do? You just go, like, you got to plug in something at home type shit? Or, like, you have to go to the mechanic?
Got to connect to the Wi-Fi.
Just to Wi-Fi? That's all it needs? It just updates like a...
It's like a phone, bro. It's like your iPhone.
I don't know if I trust that shit, man. That shit's still frightening to me.
Yeah, it is.
Because you just trust it?
It's frightening, like, when it's turning on its own and, like... You know, it's like
so that's part of the new update for everybody or something?
Everything. Well, it's not for everybody.
Okay.
The autopilot mode was like, you'd have to pay for it initially. I didn't do that initially. So now they've just included it in. I don't know who's got it. Like, I don't know everyone that's got it or not. Because it's going to sound like I'm flexing.
I mean, it's supposed to, you
know. I got a...
Only going up this year.
I guess, right? Yeah, not because...
I moved the other one, the bad one.
I got the performance. So I don't know if everybody that's got the Model 3 is getting it or not, like the dual or whatever, whatever. So I don't know if it's just... I don't know if everyone's getting it or not, period, right? Mm-hmm. But initially, it doesn't just come with your car. So they just pushed this out like less than a month ago. But now it's like... Borderline, like, self is just driving on its own, bro.
Like, your dad don't frighten you at all?
I'm getting more and more used to it.
How many times have you used it since?
I use it all the time. Like, that thing's on all the time. They're getting more and more strict with, like, keeping your hands on the wheel and stuff like that. Mm. So that part's making it safer. And I swear to God, I think the camera that they have on the inside, on your rear view mirror, is watching you.
Yeah, I wish I had that shit back in the day, bro.
I got to ride that wave still.
Already?
Yeah.
That didn't take long.
Yeah. I've had it since 2019 when it came out still, so.
What? No, I'm talking about the self-drive, bro. No,
I get it. The autopilot mode. The autopilot back then.
You had it back then?
Yeah. I had that right from the get. Just a full self-drive that I didn't have.
So what's the difference between the two then?
The autopilot is like, it'll follow the car in front of it. So if there's a car in front of me, it'll stop behind it. It'll be like two car positions behind. You can set the speed, whatever you want.
Okay.
Now.
It's just full control.
Like, let's just pretend like, I did this actually on my way here. So I put in the studio address.
Yeah.
And it just brought me to the studio. So it's stopping at the red lights, it's stopping at the stop signs, it'll stop behind the cars, it'll do the lane changes, it'll do the turns. Like, I gotta just hold the steering wheel pretty much.
It's the future, bro.
It's the present. It's the present.
But brother, I'm thinking, like, back in the day, we're sitting here watching Demolition Men and shit, and then mind they're traveling in cars that are doing all this type of crazy shit. Yo, we're living it now, yo.
Yeah.
It just don't look like what they presented in those movies to us.
It does to a degree. Somewhat. I personally.
Unless you know what he's walking around like Wesley Snipes and Demolition Man right now.
They had bad fashion sense. And by the way, they're probably walking around way different in other places, bro.
I guess.
Yeah, you go to Japan and stuff, like, it's a whole different fashion sense. Whole different world out there.
Yeah.
I still feel we're sheltered. Compared
we're behind
to how futuristic it
yeah,
is.
Yeah, we're way behind what's going on over there.
Yeah,
like, I was just talking about this yesterday.
Even the roads.
In Dubai, for example, there's barely any streetlights. It's all roundabouts.
Yeah.
Roundabout after roundabout after roundabout.
Yeah. Well, that's not new. I mean, that's like a big European thing, right?
Yeah, well, I guess that too.
Yeah. Yeah. There's a lot of European countries that are super advanced too, where they just don't talk about it. They got all kinds of stuff going on.
Yeah, we're way behind over here in North America.
Compared to them, at least.
Yeah, but I do believe the Tesla stock is up, though. So, good for them, I guess.
Elon's just
even with this incredible. Recall, even with this recall, though. Again, like, a video that I saw is
no, you got to improve, though. You get what I'm saying? So, like, there's been all kinds of recalls on all kinds of his cars. Going back to his book initially, like, there was a point where, like, yo, he needed to sell certain amount of cars to just have that money in to continue the funding. Yeah. So there's improvement on a consistent basis. And thankfully there hasn't been like anything super cringeworthy where it's like, yo, people are dying left, right, and center and cars are blowing up or whatever. So considering the fact that this is a whole nother industry that he's, or a technology that he's, you know, tapped into and evolving, yeah, we're doing pretty good, man. And it's only going to get better. Go get that stock.
Go get myself a Tesla. That's what I need to do.
You do need to do that.
I can't wait to live off the grid. I have my solar panel on the roof that'll then charge up my station.
He's got that.
And then I would
Solar
just be
City.
Able to,
yeah. Solar City, yo, he's got the whole thing set up, man.
It's on the way. Yeah. Well, not only is it 420, I'm getting an important phone call that I got to attend to, so...
Yo, shout out Gucci dropping that track.
I hope maybe we can speak to it next week. I don't know.
I got to bring up one more thing, though, before we go. Yo, did you hear the rumor?
Nah, but you maybe missed the phone call.
Sorry.
What?
Carl Winslow.
What's that? What's that about? Like, what about him?
You know what I'm talking about, though, right?
The dad and family.
Yeah. Diddy was, like, murking him.
What? Are you being serious?
I'm being serious. This is like a thing right now. You never heard this?
No.
Yeah. Is it going too far? Because that's just like, of all the people that he could get, like...
Yeah.
Like, Carl? Like, was that like a cop fetish? Or like, what was that?
This is weird. I don't even want to explore that anymore.
No?
Nah, I'm good still. But before you go, please be sure to hit the like, notification, and subscribe button. What?
I don't know. I just want to know if this popped up when that happened, though.
Did I do that?
Is that that's what the entire time that you wanted to play in? Come on, bro. Thank you for joining us. Shout out Bree. Shout out Face.
Shout out my board game.
Nah.
Yeah.
Nah.
Another one.
Get out of here. What are you
good
talking
luck to
about?
You, bro. But
good luck too.
I
can't believe I let Nas
down. You're going too far.
No.
Thank you for joining us. Be sure to hit in the comments.
Going too far.
And we'll be back next week with some more SUP.